Hey, what's up guys, it's your friend Hitesh here, and this video I will show you guys 10 steps to get extra FPS. If you guys want to tweak some particular games, I also post a link in the description below so that you can go and tweak your particular game that you want. So without further ado, let's get started. So guys, I have Intell HD integrated graphics, Intell HD 4000, and if you have any other like Nvidia or something like that, you can just follow me up. So let's quickly open Intell HD graphic control panel or any other that you have. So now you all have to do is just open the 3D first. Now we have to select the performance in general setting, and in application optimal mode you have to select enable. Then go to display. Basically we don't have to do it too much in here, just leave it as it is. Then back again, and we select the video. Then you have to do in input range, you have to select application settings, and in standard color correction you have to be at driver settings. Now you can go back to advanced, and just total color correction is to be disabled, and then go to power. Now in power you have to be at maximum performance in graphics power plan and in plugin, and when you are on the battery you have to also select on the maximum performance level. Now just quickly save it, and we are done with step 1. So now we are on step 2. Now you have to open this PC's settings, and in this you have to select advanced system settings, and under advanced select performance settings, and now select adjust for best performance, then click on apply and hit OK. After that, now you have to open it again, then go to advanced, and under adjust for best performance off you have to select background services. Then under virtual memory you have to select the change option. You have to unselect the automatic manage paging for size, and then you have to click on custom size, and under total paging size you have to select the current allocated. Just fill up the value. In my case it is 2304 MB, and in maximum size you have to multiply it with 2, which is going to be 4608. Then after that you have to click on set, and then click on OK. It will ask you to restart your PC. I can't restart it right now because I'm recording, but you can just restart your PC and come back so that we can hit the step 3. So we are on step 3. So all we have to do is just open your power settings and open up the maximum performance settings that a PC can have. I have a gaming plan option, just wait a minute. Yeah, it's under high performance, my energy management. Now go and select the change plan, and now just copy my settings that I have, never never in both, and put on sleep computer to never never. Then you have to select change advanced. Then you can also select the gaming power plan or the balance power plan from this option. Now select the wireless adapter settings and select the maximum performance in both the cases, on battery and plugged in. Then open your graphics card. I have Intell HD, so I will open it up. On battery and on plugin, select the maximum performance. Then I think we are done with it. Yeah, we are done with it. Now you have to select apply and click on OK. So we are done with this step. So let's hit the step 4. So we are on step 4. So in this step we are going to delete some unnecessary files. So go to start and hit run. So this is, you have to type it and then click on OK. So it will load up a folder. So all you have to do is just select all or just press Ctrl A, then click on delete option and we have to delete all these files. These are some unnecessary files that your system loads while you are installing or just doing something else. So after you have done completing this, you are ready to hit step 5. So we are on step 5. So in this step we are going to scan a PC. If you don't have any kind of any virus, you can use Windows Defender. Make sure to scan your PC monthly or weekly. I suggest you should scan your PC weekly, cause it will help you to increase your speed and remove some virus and skywares. Just run an antivirus scan and we are done with step 5. So we are on step 6. So all you have to do is just right click on the desktop and hit personalize. Then you have to select in background, you have to select a solid color and pick any color that you like. I like blue, so I'll pick blue, and I'm gonna change your background to a complete color. It works for me, it works for you as well, I guess. So we are done with step 6, so let's hit the step 7. So we are on step 7, so we are going to download a software which is Deflagger. You will get the software from the link in the description below. You can install it first, and now this is how you can install it. I already have the software, so I will not install it again. So after you are installed this software, now you have to open it. So what it does, it just compress those files, those are just fragmented over your hard drive. It will make your hard drive work a bit faster. Just choose a drive and click on analyze drive. It's gonna take some time. So I think its analyzing is now completed. Yeah, it's completed now. So now you have to select this option, defrag, and just click on defrag now. So it will try to just compensate the free space in your hard drive and make it work a bit faster. Now I don't have so much time, so I will stop it now. So now again you have to right click on it, and advanced, you have to check for errors. Now you have to do is just do it with your volume D and volume F with as well. When you are done doing all this with your DNF, we are ready to go on step 8. We are on step 8 and we are again going to download a software which is CCleaner. You will get the link from the description below the video. So firstly you need to install it, and this software will help your PC to clean up some crappy files. To install this software, just follow me. So CCleaner protects your privacy, it cleans your browsing history and some temporary files. It also cleans some unnecessary files that your system is saving in your hard drive, and also removes some unnecessary entries in your Windows registry and uninstall those software. Those are coming in the way between your computer speed. It's now installed, and after installing you have to run it. So this is how this program looks like. So now all you have to do is just select a Windows application and then click on analyze. So it will now started analyzing your PC, and you have to wait for some time. I don't have so much time, so I will just cancel it, and then, but you don't need to cancel it, just keep it running until it's complete, and then you have to go and click on run cleaner. So it has also many features like registry cleaner, speed boost and some other. You can just go and check it out yourself. Under tools we have some super controllable options like startup and uninstall. In startup you can just edit some unnecessary program that will run automatically when you boot up a PC. So I will just show you how can you do it. Just select anyone, select it, and then you have to disable it. Just go in the upper right corner and click on disable it, and it will disable your application. In disk cleaner you can just clean up your messy computer, and duplicate finder you will find some duplicate files that are in present in C, D, F, anywhere. So this is how this software works. You can just go to this site and upgrade to Pro, and you can do anything with it. So we are done with step 8, so let's hit the step 9. So guys, we are on step 9. So in this step we are going to install a Razer Cortex game booster. It just has some similar properties like we are done in previous step, which is C cleaner. But game booster, we all know what the game booster does. So let's quickly install it first. When you're done installing it, you just need to launch it. You need a login ID. If you don't have a login ID, you can create one, and it will take only just 2 minutes or 3 minutes, not more than that. So as you can see, my ID is ready and I had logged in now. So this is how this software looks like. So now we have to open game booster option in the above tab. So here is the game. So now we have to just open the setting and click on the game now, and it will start the game up and with some extra good FPS. So we are done with step 9, so let's hit the step 10. So finally we are at step 10. So in step 10 I will give you some tips. For example, like I have GTA 4. I don't play it as I completed the game, so I'll just deleting it. If you have any other game that you don't play now, you have just completed it, you can delete it. And for example, like if you have some application or software that you don't use it now anymore, you just can uninstall it. Which will free up some space in your hard drive and will help to run your computer a bit faster. And if you are playing some single player games, don't need to open up your net. You can just quickly open your airplane mode or just switch off your Wi-Fi signal, so it will save some extra memory. This is how you can speed up your game or get some few extra FPS, or you can just boost your game, whatever you call it. So if you like this video, don't forget to give a thumbs up, share this video with your friends, and comment. I need your comments. And yeah, I have a series in which I tweak some games. I have done a game already, which is GTA 5, and next video will be GTA 4. I will put the link in the description. So I will see you in the next video. Peace out, over and out.